get the rest of the body in the split. She just started to pop it for a nigga and look back and told me, baby, it's real. And I say I ain't got you for a second. I squeeze it and I can tell how it feels. I wish we could take off and go anywhere, but here, baby, you know the deal. And she bad, so maybe she won't, but shit, then again, maybe she will.
I really rolled with that one. So what we're doing is we're getting the connection here. Were you holding the weight? And then we're firing up your chest.
Okay.
So we're just sitting and holding this, like, 10, 20 second holds. Then we'll make it a little bit heavier and do it again.
Okay.
But I just want this hold, and neck intention I want to be back as well. I want that hold, though, to be second nature for you.
Yeah. Ooh, yeah, I feel it in my chest a lot.
And put it down, let's bring it up one more. Back of your traps, back of your neck. Good, keep squeezing. And relax.
Ooh.
All right, so let's set ourselves up. Stomach's pulled in, spine is flat on the bench. Do you feel like the seat's been raised? Oh, it's good. All right, so same, retract and slightly elevate. I wanna bring these shoulders back, neck intention back, all your scapulas turn back. Differentiate between the chest and the front delt. Keep that front delt back, squeeze in with upward intention. There you go. Keep that intention back with those shoulders. There you go. Much better. Pull that stomach in. Squeeze through. Inhale on the way down during eccentric. There you go. So let's control this back a little bit more. Keep it pinched back. Now contain it. Hold it there. Good. All this is staying back. These rear delts are pinched back. That's much better. No movement back here. This is all flat against the pad. We're not arching our back to keep it there. Keeping our spine straight.
It's like really focused to keep that.
Yes, you have to do more than one thing with your brain. Tough concept for a lot of people. The ability to multitask like that, though, is a trait that helps you, like, become a better learner. So by doing this, you're going to become a better learner. Isn't that exciting?
Yeah.
Good. Same with crossing. So if you, like, crossed your legs during this, maybe you'd be even a better learner. But don't do that. Feel in your body. There you go. There you go. So our spine is flat on the bench, our stomach's pulled in, scapulas are retracted and slightly elevated, and squeezing through an inward intention, keeping those shoulders back. Good. Inhale on the way down, exhale on the way up. Good.
Oh my God.
Back, keeping those shoulders back, good grip, control that bar, there you go. Yeah, I want a little bit stronger of a grip on those dumbbells, though.
Okay.
There you go. But now you don't have to set up over here, and you haven't stretched anything out, hauling a dumbbell over. Like. Sure. Pull that stomach in. There you go. Retracted and elevated. Squeeze up. Allow your body to relax into that position each rep. Then use your chest, squeeze in. Don't use those shoulders. Visualize that chest pulling your arms in. There you go. We get four more here, Tyler. Four, last warm-up set. Last one, squeeze up. Good.
First and then the present. Okay.
I don't know why that happens, and I'm not the only one. Like trainers say four, and clients do one. If somebody on this video can tell me why that is. Good.
go. Good. Three. Two.
Good.
Three more. Good.
Inhale. That chest open, keep those elbows up.
So now my legs are set up.
Okay.
And I'm controlling with this. I have no tension in my lower back, so I'm not leaning back or extending my hips or my midsection to the judges. I'm keeping that pulled in. And then from here, I'm able to stay back and then open up.
Good for me to sit into this. That brings my hamstring out a lot more from those videos that I watch. So I think it's...
Yeah, show me that.
So I pulled in, but then as I go to pull it in, I keep all the weight on this foot, and it makes that all of that just like flex but hang at the same time.
Yeah, so set up this leg first. So pull yourself in, so right here you're setting up your body,
yeah,
and that leg, so that when you scrape this leg in,
all that's being
is already set up.
Yeah.
So you're scraping, plant, and when you plant, that back leg twists into this. So you see how my body, this leg is going this way, this leg is going this way. And then I've already set up to where I haven't put, I can still stand.
Yeah.
I haven't set up to where I've put the weight in my lower back. I've loaded my stomach.
Yeah.
My shoulders are back. And then when I pull through, just like my side, my quarter turn, pulling, keeping that vacuum tight pull in. I'm gonna crack so I can't see myself. There you go. Last time. Right there. There you go. Good. There you go. See, and now you didn't fall off your legs. That is much better.
45 seconds and go.
Oh, really? 10 seconds. Side chest, you drop that shoulder, and you drop the stomach, and then it affected the side tri. Yeah. Mandatories for
making it more fluid,
adding more personality, how you transition your legs into it. But our focus here is to show them mandatories in pose.